Ladies and gentlemen, this is a title match for the under 75 kilo combat BJJ championship, sponsored by Sucree Dessert and Wine Bar. Introducing first, in the blue corner, he is 39 years old, fighting out of Revolution Martial Arts, under coach Rodolfo Marques, weighing in at 74.5 kilos, a black belt with an MMA record of 25 wins and 17 losses, a former champion in XFC and Rebel Championships. Please welcome Rodolfo Marques!
Rodolfo is a seasoned veteran in MMA, coming out of a killer run in Brazil, coming to Australia and tearing up the local circuit as well. So this is really a tale of two super accomplished MMA fighters and BJJ black belts throwing down head-to-head in combat jiu-jitsu. This is going to be an absolute firehouse of a fight. Killer wrestling, killer groundwork out of both these boys. I think it will really be a tale of like who has the dominant wrestling on display in this grappling match. But in saying that, Rodolfo is a crafty vet with a lot of years of experience, and this is gonna be something special. Honestly, that fight's for the title. This is gonna be something special.
Yeah, for sure. Rodolfo Marques is a veteran in the combat field, combat sports. He brought us many incredible performances. He's had some devastating losses as well, but testament to his character, he keeps coming back stronger and stronger, testing himself, representing his system, his school. It's just fantastic to have him back here again.
And his opponents in the red corner. He is 29 years old, fighting out of Adept MMA under coach Rich Poole, weighing in at 74.6 kilos, a black belt and veteran of Australian MMA. Please welcome Jason Petropolous.
Jason Petropolous, 29 years of age, out of Adept MMA, under his coach Rich Poole. I mean, Jason is an accomplished MMA fighter, has his own school, has his own business. An incredible competitor, always spectacular, loves fighting off his back. It's going to be interesting under CJJ rules to see if he chooses to attack so aggressively off his back. But hey, it's been a real contentious point all night long. But that's the rules. That's CJJ for you, and that's what makes it super exciting. Trying to find a way to finish, trying to get the fight where you want it, give yourself a chance to end it. That's
absolutely
what it's all about. And Jason is spectacular at that off his back. And let's see what he does. He loves those flying triangles, flying arm bars. His wrestling is excellent. He's got a lot of experience. He's up against the veteran. It's going to be amazing. Please welcome back Jason Petropolous.
And we are underway for the combat BJJ title fight. These boys opening up and dancing the line between slaps and collar ties from the very jump.
Yeah.
Oh, Jason wants that single collar tie. He wants that inside position. Right hand behind the neck, left hand inside the bicep. It was a bit of a gouge, was it?
Hard to see. I didn't really see it on the camera. Oh. It looks like maybe an eye poke, which is very unfortunate.
Careful, fellas. All right, here we go. It's good. Good, good.
Here it comes. Replay. Oh, yeah, bit of them actions.
All right, here we go.
Anyway, time back up in the center now.
That was like an inside leg.
Come on, that's a low kick, ref.
Wow.
It's a trip, ref, I promise.
Wow, yeah. That's twice.
In the other eye as well now.
Yeah. Come on.
Keep putting your finger in the sugar bowl, unfortunately.
Yeah, yeah. That's twice.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not trying to call Rodolfo into question, but
no,
I think things
not.
Are getting
of course
heated.
Not.
But you gotta be sharp. At the end of the day, not. You got a responsibility to look after your competitor as much as you want to try and win. Yeah, that's a pretty clear thumb in the eye.
Yeah, the boys are really trying to get that inside position. They really want to get that top position, get that takedown so they can start landing some strikes and opening up the game. So I'm not surprised to see this. We unfortunately, this is how it's going to go now and then, and it's going to try and...
For sure, but...
Clean it up a little bit. But
if it's 2 in 1 minute,
yeah,
we
exactly.
got to do better. That's what it boils down to.
100%. All right, here we go. Oh, Jason's... battering that inside leg.
Yeah. Oh, we see a nice shot entry from here from Jason Petropoulos.
He's got that
with a kimura grip from Rodolfo.
Jason's
an interesting little dance here taking place where if Rodolfo can commit on the arm and take his hand behind the back.
He's got a good grip on that. Oh,
and
boy.
Jason can try and take him towards his head.
Turn
he's taking
him
over.
He might try and take his back off this.
Jason looking to recover the legs back in front and try and recover.
Oh, nice recovery.
But as we say that, Rodolfo coming out the back door, getting out towards the back.
Well, it's always a risk. Once you get that Kimura trap, that's what it is. It's a trap, and it can take you to the armbar. It can take you to the back. It can take you to a topside crucifix. Also, it's in Jason's arm. He's in jeopardy right now.
Jason assured me that if he is viewed as tapping out in this match, it's actually just a slap. So I was like, all right, Jason, I'll take note of that.
Rodolfo Marques really leading the dance right now. He's starting to put it all together. This armbar's starting to come straight. Jason's in a lot of trouble. He's starting to get the extension. Rodolfo's trying to get... Oh, nice.
Oh, nice job. Very good.
Oh, he's
good
got
timing.
His arm free. Oh, look at that. He struck him and pulled his arm out. That was amazing.
Yeah, that's real well... really good use of the rule set.
Right?
Right? Like,
right?
That's like a clutch moment where it could have gone really bad.
Absolutely.
Played the game properly and
wow.
Came out on top in chest-to-chest half guard.
Right, here we go. Rodolfo Marques on his back. Got that inside butterfly and that half guard.
Jason with a nice underhook on the right side, it looks like. Actually, no. Rodolfo building up in this underhook now. This could be dicey now for Jason. You see him using this whizzer.
Well, this is his chance to go to the dogfight and get his head away from that cage and create a scramble.
For sure. So look for Rodolfo to try and build up to his knees here and try to climb the hips of Jason or potentially look to roll him through towards us here in the booth here. So over to Rodolfo's left. Jason's doing a really good job of keeping his base here and not allowing him to be at too off balance. But as we say that, a nice little tip there from Rodolfo. And now we're seeing Rodolfo change to this double leg. And he looks like he might be trying to go for the dog bar here, trying to hyperextend Jason's knee in this position. But Jason recovers his knee position.
And that's what makes CJJ so interesting.
Absolutely.
Is the strikes are putting you off the submission.
And as we
exactly
say that,
right.
It looks like Jason might be getting under the chin here
at
Rodolfo.
Deep.
This is actually quite effective
here. Oh,
that's
very concerning for Rodolfo Marques right now. He's in a lot of trouble.
It's a nice bite here. Looks like Rodolfo might have his hands on it. But again, Jason is a strong human being. This is, you know, not where you want to be.
He might use this to pass as well, but he's let it go. Okay. He's going to focus on the pass now. He's going to try and use some strikes. Get his
Good.
Distract him a little bit. Maybe get back on the neck.
Obviously, Rodolfo used Jason going for the guillotine to try and build up into this
Exposed
underhook.
Exposed his back. Look at
oh,
this.
Oh, but now we see Jason come back with an unhook himself and turn him back down to the mat. Very nice scramble.
You're right,
here.
George. The striking element really just puts a real hitch in the road.
Absolutely.
To for those sure. pathways that are so clean
for sure.
and so concise in a non-striking grappling situation.
Exactly right.
You really have to pick your mark to know when to throw strikes and when to go submissions because... If you go at the wrong time, you give your opponent a lot of room.
Absolutely, yeah. Some people unnecessarily, because the fact that you can strike, they'll go out there and say, oh, I can strike, I'm going to start. But when you do that, you open yourself up and you start creating habits that you usually wouldn't have in your game.
Correct, yeah. It's a really delicate dance.
Strike only if necessary to open up the game.
Yeah. or just knock him out.
Well, Victor Gentilello, I mean, I can't wait to see that main event at Fusion 5. It's going to be insane, that title defense. And he's a classic example of how brutal he can be in the clinches with strikes in a jiu-jitsu format. So there you go.
Absolutely right.
That's how it always changes. And there's not one-way traffic. Like, it's not just fighters are produced this way or that way. There's so many different ways that you can put the striking together with your grappling in any form you want. The creativity is endless. It's amazing.
For sure. You see Adolfo trying to work up on this underhook now, but Jason Orr, now we see him commit deep. As he tries to come up, looks like Jason's really sitting in the corner. If Jason can get his right knee up over the top hip here, he's going to be in a good position to go for this guillotine.
Trying to get his second hand in. Little by little. He's on the neck.
Oh, this looks like it could be.
Rodolfo has to defend. Oh, he does a good job.
Beautiful job. He's had a nice forearm frame here, trying to keep Rodolfo on his
side. Oh, look at that. Limp leg straight out. Front head. Look at that. Beautiful work. Beautiful.
Working on the front head. Looks like he might try and go to a cradle if he feels his guillotine is failing, where he'll bring his right arm around the thigh there and try to lock his hands.
He might wrap his right leg around the thigh too.
Exactly. He may do an outside reap here and try and sit him down. Beautiful work. It's a classic kind of MMA move.
Great sweeping opportunity here for Jason.
Would this be very tiring for Rodolfo carrying all of Jason's sprawl weight?
Yes, but and also tiring for Jason. So it depends on how much he's really selling out on this squeeze here. If you're holding an isometric squeeze for like 40 seconds at a time, your arms are going to get gassed. So you, again, comes back, you got to pick your mark, you know? Yep. Do you sell out and maybe finish the guy, or do you play it more safe and maybe risk giving up position, you know?
Jason's been very aggressive and offensive throughout this whole round.
He
1 minute left, and I think Rodolfo has to do something here because I think Jason's up on the scorecards.
I think, yeah, for sure. And I think as well, just generally, as much as, you know, it doesn't really play a factor in the rules, if you've been high poked twice in the very first minute, you know, you got to think the refs are thinking, man, what has this guy got to do to overcome this unfortunate start to the match, you know?
Mate, Jason's on that.
But throwing some nice hands.
Yeah, absolutely.
But then in saying all that, like I said, Rodolfo had a great Kimura trap, back take, armbar combination earlier in the match. So we'll see if he goes back to that here with this single leg position with 30 seconds to work.
I'd like to see Jason be more aggressive here, try and take the legs out from underneath him and put him back on his back. Oof.
But it's tricky here because if he takes him to his right, he allows Rodolfo to wrench this arm out and away. So really, Jason's got to try and take him towards his head and make him post so he can relinquish his Kimura grip. But again, with 14 seconds to go, it's a delicate dance. Kind of all the work might be done.
And the fence is in the way too, isn't it?
Correct,
It's interesting how strategy comes into
But you'll see
match.
Jason now trying to climb up the back.
Look at
short
that.
Short time to go. If he commits, takes it back, it'd be huge in the match. And time will elapse. Jason is fired up. Adolfo thinks he wins. This is cool.
Well, Jason did a great job. I mean, two eye pokes. Don't forget about those. Overcame those. I mean, and it's Rodolfo Marques, for goodness sakes. Look at the replay here. He's just on that Kimura trap. He did so well to sit on that hip and just really try and use that leverage to get him up and over.
This was a really cool scramble, actually, here. Yeah.
Yeah, delicate moments.
I hate to see it, you know. That was the first eye poke on the right eye, and then later he got poked again in the left.
You have a really good shot at that arm as well.
But in saying that, you can see Jason has got his legs caught around the leg of Rodolfo there to try and compromise the ability to actually apply the armbar. A couple of good guillotine attempts from Jason. So, yeah, we'll see what the judges have to say.
Very, very entertaining fight nonetheless.
Just waiting for the official judge's decision. Coming in to our MC for this evening. Looking very fine in his nice blue suit.
And we've got FFC manager, owner, Mateo, going to put the belt around the winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout has come to the judges' scorecard. For your winner by split decision, and new under 75 kilo combat jiu-jitsu champion, red corner, Jason Petropolous!
tonight. I'm here with your under 75 kilogram fusion champion. Congratulations, Jason.
Oh my God, Frank, I've been waiting for such a long time. You'd have been in the cage here interviewing me. Now I'm very happy. I can die a happy man now.
Well, we've seen you in some huge, huge fights over the years in MMA and whatnot. I mean, your contribution to the combat scene has been, you know, amazing. And here you are again, a fusion again, winning the title on a very close split decision. You know, props to Rodolfo Marques and his team, of course, on a great performance, but you're able to squeak out the decision tonight.
Yeah, look, I had a completely different game plan coming in. I also thought Rodolfo was going to shoot on me. I was going to use my guillotine. It's one of my best moves. And use that to get on top. Then all of a sudden, he wasn't wrestling me. Those eye pokes were, like, unintentional, so don't anyone boo him or anything. He's a fucking legend. I'm so honored to be able to share the cage with him. Came out with a very different game plan than I thought. He's playing very heavy collar tie. Took me about a minute to adjust. I was trying to be a bit more patient. Normally, I'm much more aggressive, but then I sort of had to get into that wrestling mode. I didn't want to be on my back with combat jiu-jitsu. It's completely tough. Different.
It is. And you did a great job, and congratulations. It was an awesome performance.
Real quick, I just want to shout out to every single person who came here, supported me, cheered for me. I love you all. I want to thank my beautiful girlfriend over there. She's the one who helped me get through so much of this, putting up with all my shit during fight camp. It was crazy, and I just want to announce, Adept MMA has just moved to a much bigger gym. We've expanded, it's enormous, 68B Tanner Street in Geelong. Come down, see the championship, woo!
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together, the under 75 kilogram fusion champion, Jason Petropolous.
What a bloke.